Hello there, guys and gals. Kirk here with Kirk Giordano, Plastering. Today, what Jason and I are going to demonstrate is how to apply Eco Stucco to this custom shower area. We're going to use a natural lime plaster, and it has its own organic natural soap as a sealer. We'll show you that part when we get to there. Sai, the owner of the company, asked me to explain why this is ecologically friendly and why it's resistant to mold and mildew. My response was, damn it, Sai, I'm an applicator, not an engineer. But what I did do, I told him, email me the specifications for it. And I asked my wife, she does a lot of arts and crafts. I said, baby, would you write it down on a piece of paper, basically the websites, for all that technical information about Eco Stucco. Don't take it from me. I'm just going to apply it, and I'm going to show you how many coats we do. Go to this website right here, storeecostucco.com. You can see I just touched the E here, and I messed it up. So I didn't write it. Anyhow, this is what we're going to do. We're going to, well, the fellow who did the shower, he's already applied the membrane, and then he's put this Wonder Board on here. So we're going to do today the fiber mesh tape. We're going to put polybond on it. I'm going to let that cure, 24 hours minimum. We are going to come back. Then we're going to put a thin set, and usually I'll mix a thin set with an acrylic so I can spread it. It's more water resistant, especially going over walls. I'm used to spreading thin set on the ground where, or the floors where it's easy. So definitely on here, I'm going to mix it with the acrylic. Then we're going to come back, and we're going to use the Deco Lime as our base coat. Then we're going to come back a fourth time. And we're going to put mural lime, that's a really beautiful shower finish, on it. Two coats, just like doing Santa Barbara, two coats. And then lastly, what we're going to do is we're going to put this black soap natural sealer in again for that organic stuff. Email this website here and you get all the technical information. Jay and I are going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to cover here the polybonds just so we can get started. Then we'll mesh tape everything and show you that part. Okay, guys, we've almost got this lick. The hard part is doing the mesh and embedding it. Actually, a contractor just now brought me these corners, so that gives me a chance to finish up these bulls and put these corners on here. And as soon as I got these on, that's going to make my life a lot easier. Then I'll finish mudding it. I got about another half hour, 45 minutes to do the mud. But again, this is all the tough stuff. The time-consuming stuff is to embed that mesh. Pain in the butt, but it's got to be done.
Alright guys, we're back on day two getting ready for this Eco Stucco project. What I'm doing now is mixing the thin set mortar, and what I wanted to tell you is that there's two ways typically you can do this. Of course, read your bag, find out what your instructions are, but typically you can mix it either with just water or with an acrylic admix. The reason you would do an acrylic admix is it increases the strength, it makes it more water resistant, and it actually makes it a lot easier to apply if you're doing it on walls or ceilings. If you're just doing a mortar mix on the ground, you can do just water and it'll be okay.
Okay guys, day two. Thin set. Jay mixed up some white so you can see what I'm doing. What I'm doing is I'm hydrating these walls, because if I try to spread this thin set over this material here, I will burn out on one wall, because it'll be as fast as I spread this, it'll suck up the moisture out of it. So what I'm doing is, I've been in here about 10 minutes. I'm just using a water hose because he's mixing right out here, goes straight through the window. A lot of ways to hit a wall. I can use a Hudson sprayer, a little pump bottle, a brush, a roller. This is the fastest way. So I've been in here about 10 minutes, and what I'm trying to do is get all the suction even. And then once I get the suction even, I will begin to spread. And why am I doing this? I want to use skill, not muscle. Because I will burn out if I use all my muscle, just one stroke and it already hardens up. So it's a good tip right here, guys, if you're going to do this. just about out of here. I've wet all these walls prior, which made applying it easy for me, but it's taking a while for this to set up. If a new guy, if you don't have that much experience with the hand tools, you can just spread right over a dry wall, but you better be on each wall. I prefer to do it this way and do the whole thing. And now what I'm doing is I'm coming in and I'm... All right, guys, Kirk here. Let me tell you where we're at with this. Okay, the fella already did all the wonderboard and the waterproof membrane. We did the polybond, we did the mesh, we did the thin set. Today we're doing deco lime. Deco lime actually spreads out kind of like paper mud. It's actually quite simple. Side thing, it's only for professionals, but this is the easy product to apply. Anyhow, I'm gonna go ahead and apply this now. And then we're gonna come back possibly next week and do the two coats of mural lime with the black soap. Here I go. Of course, this product is white, so you're not really going to see it. White on white really doesn't show very well. Again, we'll be applying mural lime, and this product, by the way, it goes on so simple for experienced applicators. It's like doing tape and mud, very, very simple. We'll see you soon.
All right, guys, we're back. We are on the final coat. We are on the mural lime section, and what I'm going to show you now is how to mix the mural lime product. What you got to do first to start is you take your color pigment, and you're going to use about a half a quart of water, and you mix up your color pigment into a paste. Now, once you've got your color pigment mixed up, you're going to then add to about 2 quarts of water, and then you're going to add about half your product in the mural lime bag. And this is just for the initial mix. What can happen with these things is you see it's pretty dusty. The water takes a second to get into the product. You gotta be careful not to add too much to start, otherwise you end up with too soupy a product to use. Then I will see you guys in a few minutes. All right, guys, so we're back. I've let it slack up now. If you remember, I put a little over around 2 quarts of water. I can now add the rest of my product and the rest of the water to get it to the consistency that I want for what we're doing inside. So, here we go with the rest of the product.
Back again, and this time we're doing the fun stuff, the mural lime. I'll show it to you when I get started with it. But first, the deco lime. This is the first time Jay and I actually did deco lime the day prior. I usually do it the same day, and I'm going to keep doing it the same day because now I've got to wet everything. If you do the deco lime the same day and just allow it to cure, it makes the application of the mural lime a little bit better. You don't have to do all this, and what I'm doing now is I'm hydrating these walls because the mirror line will suck up. And I don't want it to evaporate too fast, so this is somewhat necessary. Also, when I actually did the deco lime, I took my corners with a brush, a little tiny brush, I floated it all, we got all the imperfections out, because any imperfections are going to show. So let's see here. What I want to do is I'm looking at the wall and I'm hydrating it to where it's all the same consistency. Sometimes the walls dry a little different than the others. That's why it takes, really got to look at it to see. I want this wall hydrated the same or as close as possible. Now what I'm going to do, guys, is we're going to do the mirror lime now. And as I said before, this deco lime and mirror lime, this is the easiest spreading product that I've used. It's like tape and mud. If you mix it just right, kind of like whipping cream, it goes on very well. Okay, now that we've moist cured these walls, this is how I'm going to start. I'm going to hit this wall here. I'm going to do the barrel ceiling. Come back, hit this entire wall, then the shower wall here. So, and of course, this product. All right, guys. Now that I've moist cured the wall and I've allowed the water to evaporate in, I don't want standing water because that'll blister this. So we don't want any standing water. Now it's about just perfect for this application. So what I do is, and then, by the way, this color actually lightens when it dries. So I'll get started. Real tight. I'm putting this on tight, guys, because it's going two coats. Okay. Just like butter.
Go thinner on the first one. Yeah.
Okay. Give you an idea how that goes on. I'm going to go ahead and hit this barrel ceiling. Too is the total depth of this mirror line is only a 16th of an inch, meaning you can achieve that in two or three coats. If you're not that good with the hand tools, do it in three. But the idea is put the first coat on thin, put it on just covering the wall and tight. So when you're done, you don't want more than a 16th of an inch on this. Got the first coat on it. You see right here where it's turning light, that's drying. It's all going to dry much, much lighter. Anytime you're doing back-to-back systems, the next coat is going to bring it back a little bit darker. See, this is dry, that's dry. And before it all gets dry, I want to put my second coat on this. So it all cure together. And here we go. I'm going to start exactly where I started the last time. Inside this little entryway and then take the dome. Okay, here we go.
Well, I can't see much. It's the exact same color. All right, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and spread out the whole thing. It's gonna take me a while, so I'll show it to you when we're completely done with this. So give me time to go over this, and I'll show you the how we achieve the finish. All right, guys. Right now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna get rid of all the cat faces, chatter marks, things like that. This does take a lot of elbow grease, so I'm gonna be doing this for about 20 minutes to get it all compressed tight. So now watch what I'm doing. I'm not putting it here, I'm putting it about right here. And I'm gonna use both hands, and I'm gonna use a lot of pressure. I'm gonna go this way, that way, in between pipes, but just come every which way as we stand up. This way, that way. You may not be able to see what I'm doing with this. Go in slow motion, like that. Take it the other way, take it this way. In upward motions, everything is upward motions. We go from the top, get this barrel sealing out, that way, this way, and again, I use two hands, I'm pretty strong, but this really takes a lot of elbow grease. Give me about 20 minutes and I'll show you the final product.
Alright guys, so I'm out here once again for the last step in the Eco Stucco process. What we need to do now is seal the Muralime in the shower. So what we have is a black soap. Now this stuff, it's an organic cleaner. It's been around for thousands of years. The Romans came up with it. It's a mixture of olive oil and ashes. You can use this to clean your floors, your pans, your kitchens, your bathrooms, everything. What we're gonna use it for is a sealer. I'm gonna mix 3 to 5 scoops of this stuff, little spoonfuls, every quart of water, and then you spray it onto your Eco Stucco, your Muraline, and that forms a crystalline, impenetrable water barrier. All right, guys, I got all my scoops in my sprayer, and I wanted to show you this. I wish you could smell it through the camera. Hopefully you can see it. It's pretty dark, and mine is pretty loose because it's been sitting out in the sun in the truck all day. And what you might find is when it's cold, if it's been in your, you know, pantry or wherever, it gets very wax-like. When it gets wax-like, what you can do is get your water and microwave your water, because hot water will help it disperse easier. Don't microwave the soap. And so I got it in here. Once you get it in there, get it all dispersed. You don't have to use a sprayer. I like to use a sprayer because it's easier for me, but you can also apply it just like a regular wax, just onto your surface. It can actually be applied instead of beeswax in a lot of finishes and give it a nice shine. But anyway, now we're all set. I'm gonna bring this in there and you'll see my dad applying it.
All right, guys, we're done with the spray. And here's a light buff. You just take it and just very gently light buff. And you can do this a couple times. We're gonna get out of here in about 15 minutes. If they wanna put another coat or two today, later on after it sets, they can do that. I've already showed it to them. Anyhow, Michael, I'm sorry I've been in your way so much. This is the fella who did all this and had to put up with us walking in and out of his floors.
It was a pleasure, a total pleasure. Yeah. Appreciate working with you, Kirk.
All right. Well, as usual, Jason and I will see you folks on the next one.